Their target was principally aimed at customs to leave the border areas for them to have unfettered smuggling. I can assure you that since the restoration of that control, officers have seized over 2,947 bags of rice, 1,875 liters of PMS, 18 units of vehicles, 4 motorcycles, 10 sacks, and 1,658 wraps, or what we call a coconut size of cannabis sativa. That is the one we popularly call Indian hemp. 159 cartons of sugar, and so on and so forth.
Yes. Okay.
Well, it's now.
Where are you going to again?
Let's enter. Through borderland.
No, we have local companies that are manufacturing sugar.
I'll move this way.
Wait, wait.
I even make it like that.
The oil.
I'm saying
it has not come back to normal yet. You know, it's very easy to destroy, but to build is very. We wish to reiterate that the continued attack on operatives of Nigerian Customs Service and other sister agencies will not deter us from the continued performance of our legitimate rights and duty. Let me use this opportunity to appeal to parents and guardians to prevail on their words to children and youth of communities to stop compromising and siding with the smugglers and other criminals. As we are still talking, smuggling is an offense. We are calling on our communities not to side with smugglers. Let them expose them so that they will be arrested and the local production will go on unfettered. If you side with a smuggler, you are siding with unemployment. You are siding with food insecurity. You are siding with national insecurity. Because the smuggler go for anything that will give him money. It is not only rice smugglers smuggle. They can go for weapons. They can go for drugs. And if we don't control these things, hardly will me and you sleep in our house.